Hey guys, we're here again today at Hard Racing, working on our Kawasaki Z125 Pro project bike. And today we're going to be installing this monster Brock's alien head full system. You may be wondering, why do you say monster? Look at the size of this header. This thing is a monster. That is the OD on the majority of this tube. 38 millimeters. That's huge. That is absolutely huge. Brock's is well known for making some of the best performing exhausts on the planet. They do a lot of dyno work to get the best horsepower out of it. And that would explain why this header is so large. So obviously it starts stock size and then tapers out bigger and bigger to get to the back, and then you have their alien head canister, which is one of the nicer looking exhausts on the market. They come in this chrome, basically the standard stainless, but it looks more like chrome, but it's actually just polished stainless. And they also have a black version as well, which it looks just like this, but it's just all black, matte black. And the beauty also of the Brock's 18 millimeter bung, which is awesome for you guys that want to tune your fuel controllers for a wideband sensor. It screws right in there. So if you're going to do a ZAFM or Dynajet auto tune or a wideband, you don't have to go out and get your header welded. So that's a big plus. Obviously they have an adapter plug for your stock one. If you don't want to use that, that's fine, no big deal. But at least you have the option for the 18 millimeter wideband sensor or the stock sleeve down version. They both will work on the same header. But this thing is definitely a beauty. Huge, huge header tube. And the install, as always, very straightforward and easy to do. And we'll show you that next.
All right, so the first step to removing your stock exhaust is going to be removing this lower cowl, and you do that by removing these two bolts here and the two bolts on the opposite side. So the next thing you want to do is remove the stock O2 sensor. Okay, so just a quick tip here, go ahead and remove the stock O2 sensor from the plug. That way it frees this up so that as you loosen this, it can turn and it doesn't bind. So as you turn, what you want to do is keep turning the plug so it doesn't get all wound up. Just like that. All right, so the next step is going to be to remove the rear muffler bolt using a 12 millimeter socket. You don't have to, I'm just lazy today and I'm going to use our impact wrench. So the next step is going to be to remove these header bolts here. You want to do that by supporting with your hand the muffler. Be careful, make sure obviously it's not hot, and then use your same 12 millimeter socket. Comes off just like that. So we weighed this real quick on the scale and it's almost 9 pounds. And the Brox is only 3.5 pounds. That's less than half the weight. Okay, so the first step we're going to do is to back these two bolts out and install this frame bracket behind your rear set. As you can see, our foot controls look a little different because we have the driven rear sets. Same concept, we're just going to remove these two bolts and slide this frame bracket behind it into position. So once you've gotten the frame bracket installed just like this, go ahead and hand tighten in the bolts. Okay, so next you want to go ahead and install the header like so and just hand tighten the nuts. So next, go ahead and slide the canister on. Do it nice and slowly because it is a tight fit. All right, so the next step, you're going to take the supplied bolt and washer, put it through the hole, and then take on the back side, take the supplied washer and nut and put it on the other side. Okay, so next go ahead and cinch down the header bolts. Alright, and you want to install the last spring on the back side of the flange that goes to the header. Okay, so next go ahead and install the spring, one of the springs on the canister. Okay, so next you want to go ahead and wiggle everything, make sure it's exactly where you want it, it's aligned where you want it, and then you'll want to tighten down this bolt and these two bolts. Okay, so now that you've got your exhaust all bolted up, you want to, on the final step, reinstall your O2 sensor. Okay, and obviously you'll want to install the insert that comes with your pack before you install your O2 sensor. Okay, and one last thing, if you have some anti-seize, you want to put it on your O2 sensor and on the insert. Okay, and before you fire it up, what you want to do is go ahead and wipe it down so that you can wipe off the fingerprints. Okay, so now it's time to fire it up. If you liked our video, please be sure to give us the thumbs up by clicking down here. And if you want to watch more of our videos, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. We will be doing more videos for the Z125 on more products, so definitely check that out. You can also check us out on our website, hardracing.com. We also have our Facebook page, and we also have Instagram and Twitter. So just let us know. You can also email us for more information at hardracing.com.